The bus belonging to Link Bus Company was coming from Bundibugyo district and heading to Kampala. It veered off the road at Sebitori in Kabarole district, just a few kilometers from Fort Portal town, causing the death of 20 people. One other person is said to have died this morning at the hospital. Police, ambulances, relatives and friends were seen rushing to the scene to inquire about their loved ones who were on this bus. The acting director of road traffic, Lawrence Nuwabine, says the investigations into what exactly caused the accident are a complex situation for the investigators. Nuwabine says the death of the bus driver had complicated their investigations.
It's unfortunate that today we have lost another one, and the total is 21 persons that died in this fatal road crash. Honorable Minister, sir, this is a complex investigation, and I want to thank you and your team for putting in place a joint investigation team. The driver died at the scene, and usually in investigations, the driver is our first target in investigation. Unfortunately, died.
The State Minister for Works and Transport, Musa Echweru, today visited the accident scene.
And now it's just slightly, it's
deeply saddened. I came this morning to the scene of this accident on behalf of government to work with a team of our experts, our local experts, from the engineering department, from the forensic department, and from law enforcement department.
A team of investigators from the police traffic directorate were also present, including mechanical engineers, forensic experts, and highway experts on road crash investigations.
I'm here to window dress or to just show the face of government. We have come to try to establish the problem and what could have gone wrong so that we avoid a repeat of this kind of accident in future. That is basically what brings us here first. A repeat should never be allowed.
Echweru also confirmed that the government has suspended the Link Bus Company's license to ascertain whether the company's buses are mechanically sound.
We are suspending the, because you see, apart from this investigation, we also want our teams, our experts, to look at the whole fleet of those buses in that particular company to see whether they are mechanically sound. That's not to suggest that this one may have been mechanically deficient, but we are just saying let's suspend that first, and if we find that this was a unique case, then we shall put them back on the road. But that has happened, and that is going to happen.
Affect us, but what we are going to do when we get that letter, we don't know what is in the content of that letter because we've not got it. When we get it, we shall look at the contents, then we shall be able to explain ourselves. Because you may even find maybe the driver was not responsible for this. So we shall, depending on what the letter requires us to do, we shall explain ourselves to the ministry.
Meanwhile, Fort Portal Regional Referral Hospital says the lack of a CT scan has inconvenienced them in treating the accident victims. By yesterday, the hospital had received 57 people who were involved in the bus accident that has now left 21 people dead.
Wali wabamu vetu awereza ku high levels for services zetu taina wano specialized care kati ngoyo yafunye injury yomugongo primary farinze mulago kubanga tetuina CT scan and that specialized care the spinal clinic.
The facility serves the districts of Kabarole, Fort Portal, Bunyangabu, Kasese, Bundibugyo, Ntoroko, Kamwenje, Chenjojo, Chitagwenda, and Chegegwa.
We have to attend the meeting with OPD, Ngabakatuka, Naye, Kumalizane. We have to admit that we have to abalala bagenze mu health centers endala malwaliro amalala nga Kabarole Hospital, Finzi ne walala.
Among those who died in the accident was the facility's staff member, Susan Alum, who was in charge of the isolation center where Ebola patients are treated. Alum was heading to Kampala for her master's degree graduation. Some of those who survived the accident described it as luck. Yasin Ibrahim, who was seated near the driver, says the bus was riding at a high speed before they heard a loud burst. Report by John Antusingwide for the news.